Welcome to Pest Control 101. Pest control is a very important aspect of any home maintenance program. Termites alone are responsible for over $5 billion per year in home damage in the U.S., and the average cost to repair a home is about $30,000. In addition to the financial cost, these infestations can also affect the health of your family by causing increased respiratory and allergy problems. This video covers the types of pests that you need to protect your home from, the three steps of the battle against pests, the area around your home that you should inspect and clean to prevent infestations, and our recommended timing for doing these inspection and cleaning tasks. Let's begin by looking at the three types of pests which can invade your home. Termites. Termites destroy wood from underneath the surface of the wood, leaving only a hollow shell. Without early detection, termites can cause tens of thousands of dollars of damage to your home. Insects. These pests include ants, bedbugs, carpet beetles, clothes moths, cockroaches, houseflies, mosquitoes, silverfish, and spiders. Insect pests carry diseases, and their droppings can cause respiratory problems and increased allergies. Animals. Animals that can infest your home include bats, mice, rats, moles, squirrels, and chipmunks. These pests can also carry diseases, and their droppings too can cause respiratory problems and increased allergies. The battle with these pests involves three steps. Inspection, to detect evidence of pests and the conditions that lead to pests. Prevention, by cleaning and erecting barriers to entry. Extermination or removal, to get rid of pests if infestations have already begun. Now let's discuss the areas you should inspect and clean around your home. There are 10 areas around your home which you should regularly inspect and clean to prevent infestation by pests. Foundation. You should inspect foundation walls, both inside and outside, for earthen termite tube tunnels that connect the termite colony and the moist soil to the wood. Termites need to return to their nests once a day, and so they create these dirt tunnels to travel back and forth. These tunnels are usually 1/4 to 1/2 inch wide, and are half-round in shape, and may be found on masonry foundation walls, basement walls, and even on the surface of metal pipes. While you're inspecting your foundation, you should also check that no soil or shrubs are touching your house. Another telltale sign of termites can be finding piles of their droppings, which they discharge from their nests. Also look for any cracks or loose mortar, and patch them. You should also check for tunnels around the openings where pipes enter a foundation wall, or the wall of a house. If you find openings around pipes, then use caulking compound to seal the openings. Also, the spring and early summer is mating season for termites, so during these times watch for swarms of flying insects or for clusters of discarded wings near your house. Check unfinished crawl spaces for termite tunnels and for places where soil may touch the wall. Make certain these spaces are well ventilated so that moisture can escape and not attract termites to a damp area. Lastly, be sure that any firewood or untreated wooden materials are kept at least 20 feet away from your home and elevated at least 6 inches off the ground to help prevent termite infestation. Wood siding. If you have wood siding or wood corner boards, you should check this wood for carpenter ants, wasp nests, and for any evidence of termites. Use a sharp instrument such as an ice pick, screwdriver, or awl to probe any wood that you suspect may be infested. If you can press deeper than 1/2 inch, then it is likely you have a problem with termites or dry rot. Also check to ensure that wooden trellises and fences are at least 12 inches away from your wood siding or corner boards. Attics. Check your attic for signs of droppings from animals such as mice, rats, or bats, and look for nests of squirrels or chipmunks. Make sure that any ventilation ports or openings in your attic are correctly screened off to keep out pests. Basements. Check your basement for droppings from mice or rats, and look for nests of squirrels or chipmunks. Check for clusters of discarded termite wings. Also look for cracks in the floor or loose basement wall mortar, especially where the wall meets the floor, and patch any cracks that you find. You should pay particular attention to basement window wells, where debris tends to accumulate, as this can provide termites with access to basement window frames as well as to moist soil. Garage. Inspect your garage for droppings from mice or rats, and look for any nests of squirrels or chipmunks. Inspect where the slab or foundation meets the wall for evidence of termites. Also check any pipes that go through garage walls, and caulk around them as necessary. Eaves. Inspect your roof eaves and remove any wasp nests, beehives, hornet's nests, or spider webs. Sinks, cupboards, and closets. You should inspect and clean the corners in your cupboards and closets, as well as openings under baseboards, in floors, and behind kitchen drawers. In addition, inspect and clean the space under your kitchen and bathroom sinks, your exhaust fans, and around all water pipes, toilets, and other plumbing fixtures. Hardwood floors. If you have hardwood floors, you should look for signs of any discoloration, which can be an indication of termites attacking from underneath the floor. Stagnant water. If you have water that stays for long periods after it rains, or under a leaky outside water faucet, you should fix these areas, as they will be breeding grounds for insect pests. Termite monitors. Lastly, if you have placed termite monitors around the outside of your foundation, which is a good idea in general, then you will want to inspect these monitors to check for any indications of termite activity. If during your inspection and cleaning you detect infestations by termites, insects, or animals, you should immediately consult a professional pest control company, or take appropriate action to exterminate or remove the pests. If you are uncomfortable doing the inspection and cleaning yourself, then you should bring in a pest control company to do it for you. Now let's talk about timing. We suggest that you conduct this inspection and cleaning at least twice a year. Once in May at the beginning of the spring, and once in November before the winter. Cleaning the areas that are susceptible to pests will help prevent infestation, and frequent inspection allows early detection, which can prevent costly damage from spreading. Infestation of your home by pests can cause expensive damage to your home, as well as leading to respiratory and allergy health problems. We hope this video has helped you to understand the types of household pests, the steps in the battle, the 10 areas which you should routinely inspect and clean, and the importance of doing this on a timely basis. This video is powered by HomeWizard.com, personalized reminder software used by home service providers who really care about their customers.